Git is a distributed version control system, and what that means is that it allows groups of developers to work on the same code base. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to install Git. Just a fun fact, Git was created by Linus Torvalds. He is the original creator of Linux. Thanks for watching Automate Now. I'm Marco Cruz. Let's dive in. To begin the download process, we're going to head over to git-scm.com/downloads. As you can see here, as of the date of recording, the latest version is 2.33.0. And here are the different operating systems that are compatible. So I'm going to be using Windows, so I'm going to click Windows here, and this is going to start the download process. The download is complete, so let's go ahead and run this executable and click Next here. This is the default location where it's going to get installed, so I'm going to click Next. And here you can leave all the defaults. I like to turn this off right here. And then click Next. Next. And here you can leave the default again. I like to use Notepad++ though, so I'm going to select that and click Next. And this is talking about the default branch name. The default value is master, or you have the option of using main. I'm going to be using main, so I'm going to click this and click Next. Next. Next, next, next again, and next again, next. There have been some recent changes on the way that we are able to commit code over to Git. So this is a new manager here, Git Credential Manager Core. So I'm going to be showing you guys in some later videos what this is all about. But for now, I'm just going to leave the default here and click Next. Next, next, and that begins the installation. When the installation finishes, you're going to have the option here of launching Git Bash. Git Bash is a desktop application that allows us to run Git commands. So I am going to open that and then undo this here and click Finish. And this is the Git Bash window here. So what I'm going to be doing here to make sure that the installation was successful, I'm going to type in git --version. And here we can see that it was installed successfully, and this is the version that we got. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.